done a new topic that is how to create the event from a Boolean indicators. So as we know, Boolean indicators can give four type of outputs. One will be true, another will be false, another will be from true to false, another will be from false to true. That means we can see this is your Boolean, so it can be true, it can be false, so this is false, this is true, and it can be from true to false, it can be from false to true. And we want a separate event for each type of cases. So how to utilize these cases, let's see. So we have just created a two button dialog where the input is are you sure, and if we'll do that yes, I'm sure, output will be true, and if that will be no, if I press no, then that will be output will be false. So this is like when we'll press yes, output will be true, when we'll press no, output will be false. And depending on these true false, we have to create an event. So that true false we have given to the Boolean input, Boolean outputs. So you can see this is your Boolean. So to create an event from this indicator, we have to use a property of this Boolean, that is your value signaling property, this property. So we have to just click it, we have a property like this. So if we have this property, then we can create a event. If I will give this property, we can create a event. So as you know, this is directly we are giving output to this value signaling input. So what will happen, whatever will be the output, whether it may be true or may be false, there will be an event. There will be an event. So you can see, if I will hit run button, it asking like, are you sure? Yes, I am sure. Then output will be true. Then event will happen. That event happened from indicator. So if I will press no, also there will be an event happen from an indicator. So if you want that when the output, I will press yes button, then there will be event. So what to do? Just I have to create a case structure, and you have to wear this, and in a for the, when that means this case structure will be true when I will press yes button. So when I will press yes, out case structure will be true, then this signal will come to value signaling. So that means there will be event. And in case of false, we don't need a event. So that means we can keep directly the value property to this, and change to right and value property to this. So you can see like here when the I'll press yes button, then there will be event. When I'll press no button, there will not be event. So like this, when I'll press yes button, there is event happened. If I'll press no button, there will be no event. So this is like I categorize that when the output will be true, then there will be event. If you want the reverse way, just you have to swap this case. So like make this case false. So here when I'll press yes, there will not be any event. So if I'll press yes, no event. If I'll press no, that means false, there will be event. So if it false, then there will be value signal. Now the next two case is your true to false or false to true. So true false is over, now true to false and false to true. So how to relate that? So here to get that whether that is from true to false or from false to true, we have to use this old value and a new value of the Boolean. That means in each time there should be an event so that we can find what is the old value and what is the new value. So here we just have, we don't need this case structure, remove case structure. And that means when there will be, whether you press yes or pressed no, there will be event, and from the event we will decide it is from true to false or from false to true. So that means we'll just build array. So here old value and new value. So here this is old value and new value, so that means maybe true false or maybe a false true. That is we are making an array, and we have to convert that array to number. So because we want a case structure to decide whether that is from true to false or false to true. So as you can see, this is old value and then new value. So that means 0 and 1 means false and true. 0 1, if that is 1, then that means that is from false to true. And if that is 2, means from true and false, that is true to false. So there will be two caseful arrays, one will be 1, another will be 2. So 1 means that is true to false, so false to true, and 2 means your true to false. So you just have to insert like this, and you can write like event from true to false. Sorry, false to true. 1 means false to true, and your same thing if we have 2, case number 2, that is from true to false. True to false. So as you can see, like when I'll press yes or no, whatever event will happen, because directly we are giving signal to value signal in of the boolean. So after that event will happen, you have to decide that event is from true to false or false to true. So that means old value and new value. If old value is true, new value is false, that is from true to false. And old value is true, new value is false, then that means 1 and 0, that means 2, that means true to false. So let's see whether it's working or not. So as you can see, if the previously it was false, when I'll press yes, that will be your false to true. So event happened from true to false, so that means it is reversed. So make this case rearrange this case, shift diagram to 1, and this is 2. So just in the reverse way. So let's see again. That means this is true. If I press no, that means it will convert to false. That means true to false. So true to false. Event happened from true to false. Similarly, now this is false. If I press yes, that will be from false to true. So event happened from false to true. And if you can see that is true, if I press yes again, that will be true again. So no event. So no event, because that is the case 0, so nothing will going to happen in case 0. So in case 1, that means that is from true to false. In case 2, that is from false to true. So this is all about our today's topic.